how to upload and work with files in UiPath Autopilot for everyone. That is what we are going to see in this video. Hi everyone, welcome back to the next video in the UiPath Autopilot series, where we are trying to understand Autopilot in a step-by-step manner. My name is Mukesh Kala. I am a 4-times UiPath MVP and a LinkedIn top voice. I have shared my LinkedIn details on the page. Feel free to send me a connection request. Happy to be part of your network. Also, you can scan the QR which you see on the screen and join our WhatsApp community to receive latest notifications from the channel, right? Before getting started, in case you are an absolute beginner to Autopilot for everyone and want to explore the agentic as well, feel free to explore this complete playlist where we are covering all these topics in a step-by-step manner. You would find the playlist link in the description. Right. And lastly, in case coming to the channel for the first time, haven't already subscribed, please consider subscribing to the channel to get the next videos in the same playlist. Having said that, let's get started. Okay, so this is my Autopilot for everyone, right, which we have configured. We have configured all of these prompts. We have seen how do you upload all of that into the previous videos, right? But one of the interesting feature of Autopilot is that we can also upload files and we can do a lot of things in Autopilot in general, right? Now today, before I go to the practicals, what I have done is I have created some of the sample files which I am going to upload and ask relevant questions to it. You guys can also have upload some of the files, ask the question and try it on your own, right? And before we directly jump to the demonstration of the file upload, let's quickly try to see in theory what exactly is it, and there are some important point which you should remember before you actually go and start using the file upload and the analyze functionality, right? So let me quickly go back to my presentation and let's quickly talk about what exactly is this, right? So you have an upload icon in the chat box where you can drag and drop a file. You can click on upload and it will ask you to browse for the file. Also, you have an option to drag and drop the file and that will attach the file to the Autopilot for everyone, right? So that is how you upload the file. Now the next thing is when you actually click on the send button, what happens in the background? Autopilot ingests the files and analyze it, making the content of the file available for the queries, right? So as soon as you upload, this happens in the background. And lastly, once the analysis is completed, you can ask Autopilot for questions and other information which is part of the file, and Autopilot would give you the relevant information. So in simple terms, you have an option to upload the file, drag and drop the file, it will analyze it, and then it will give you an option to upload option to ask more questions and get the relevant information from the documents. Okay, now when it talks about the file format, we have an option to use CSV, we have an option to use JSON, TXT, PDF, PNG, JPEG, TIFF and TIFF, right? So all of these type of files you can just drag and drop, it will analyze and you will get the respective answers. Okay, now there are some important point which as a developer I need to understand about uploading or analyzing of this file. The first point being Autopilot cannot understand PDF that exceed more than 5 pages. So if you have a document which is exceeding more than 5 pages, Autopilot cannot understand that, and for that we might need to use the advanced features like context grounding, which we would see into the upcoming videos, right? But if you are directly uploading a file to Autopilot and the file, let's say it's a PDF and it has more than 5 pages, so it might not understand. Okay, the next thing is it can search relevant section of the PDFs and provide answers based on that search. Yes, definitely it can do that. As a result, the text results such as summarize the document could lead to incorrect result. Now what does it mean? Currently whenever we upload a file, it analyzes it, and when you ask a question, it is going to a relevant section and give you that information. Now in such situation, if you just go and say summarize this document, you might get irrelevant response. For that you need to use some of the advanced techniques. Okay, the other thing is, which is a bit important, the data only persist in the current chat session, right? So as soon as you drag and drop to a document, you ask some question, that information, that knowledge is only for that respective chat session and it's not carried forward to the other chats, right? So the data persists only in the current chat session. If you start a new chat, the information from the previous chat cannot be retrieved. Okay, so as of now, these are the things which you should remember when you are working with files upload. Having said that, we always has an option to come out of these drawbacks or come out of these limitation using context grounding and all, which are kind of a bit advanced feature. So we are not discussing that today. But if you are specifically dragging and drop working on the files, these are the thing you should remember, right? And with that background, let's go back to Autopilot and see all of this in action. Okay, so now to get started with the file upload, right, I will go back to my folder and I have a couple of documents with me. I have a resume, I have a project documentation, a medical report, a customer feedback, and some of the contract agreement as well, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use these files and let's try to analyze how Autopilot is able to respond to them, right? So let's quickly open the contract agreement, right? And here is the contract agreement, right? This is blah blah blah. It has some information. I have created a dummy kind of an agreement, right? So you could relate it to some agreements and it is on the TXT format, right? So I'll just minimize this and I'll go back to the Autopilot, which is this, and let's try to drag and drop the file directly into the Autopilot screen, right? So I'll just go and I drag and drop the file here, right? And that is uploading the contract. Now what do you want to do with the file? You can actually go and ask some of the questions, right? So I have already read the file. So what I have got is I have got some questions which I'll just directly go and copy paste here. What is the termination clause, right? And now what is happening in the background, it will go, it will analyze the document, understanding your request, right? So it's going to take some time. So based on the contract agreement provided, a termination clause is as follows, right? So based on the file which I have uploaded, now it is able to give me the answer, right? Other things are, I could also go and check for the information, something like this. Does this contract mention the GDPR compliance, right? And let's see. And the good part is, if you see here, it says that if the party contracts, it has a penalty of 2 lakhs rupees and all, right? It says that yes, the contract GDPR, confidentiality, the agreement complies with HIPAA, data encryption, GDPR. So if you go back to the contract, right, so this was our contract, and it says that yes, it has something related to GDPR, it has the contract value, it has that termination clause as well, right? And you can see that it is signed by this ABC, who is the CEO, right? So if I just go and ask Autopilot, maybe just like who is the CEO, right? I just made a spelling mistake, right? Let's see. And based on the contract, it says that it is signed by this guy, which is this Rahul Khanna, and this works, right? Now, as we have discussed during the theory, as soon as I go here and I create a new chat, all that information is gone. And now if I go here and I ask that does this contract mention the GDPR compliance, Autopilot would not have the context, right? So we don't have the document here, so I'm sorry, blah blah blah, it has no information. However, you can always go to these three lines and here you have that previous chat, right, which already has the document embedded. So you can always come back and refer it from here. Okay, so between the chat, it's not possible. Okay, so that was about the contract. Let's see what other files I have. I have a comma separated file which looks something like this. I am also looking at it for the first time. Let's see what we have. Okay, so we have a CSV file which seems like to be a product feedback from some customers, right? So we have some customers, they have given this information, ratings, some date and some product, right? So I can close this. I just say don't save, and let's try to put that into the new chat, right? So I'll go create a new chat, and then I'm going to this time drop the CSV file. Okay, and I am, let's say, managing this company, and the customers has provided the feedback. Now I want it to summarize all the feedbacks, right? So I can actually go and say that summarize all the negative feedback for me from that file which I just uploaded, right? And meanwhile that is opening, I think this was the file, right? Yeah. Okay, so let's see what was the negative feedback. I think this received a defective unit, and then it was a very slow delivery, right? So now I have asked it to actually go and summarize the negative feedbacks, right? So you can think it of a scenario where you have people who are, you have a lot of data, and then you are asking it to summarize only the negative feedback, positive feedback, and it has given you a good response saying that based on the customer feedback, here is the summary of the negative feedback. Running shoes has a rating 1. The customer is Rajesh. This is by Jane. Very slow delivery. Received a defective product. The two instances of the negative feedback highlight what issues. It highlights the product quality, delivery, and it has also given you some suggestions, right? The good part is, since it is coming as a CSV file, it is also giving you the sources, which is like the customer feedback row number 5, and the other customer feedback was on row number 2. How cool is that, right? So now the other part is, you can also ask it some theoretical kind of questions, right? If I just go and say here, what is the overall customer satisfaction rating, right? So I have a lot of reviews, and I, being, let's say, the product owner, I want to know the overall customer satisfaction rating. You can always do that. To calculate the overall satisfaction rating, it has calculated, since we have the 5 customers out of 15, 5 customers, 3 out of 5, and the complete calculation it has given, right? And as we have discussed in the previous sessions, Autopilot is also giving you some of these options as well, right? What product has the highest customer satisfaction rating? Can you create a chart? And all those things you can actually go and do, right? So here it says, can you create a chart showing the distribution of ratings? Let's try that, right? And I'm not sure whether this will work, because I haven't already tried creating a chart, but let's see. So it says searching for the customer feedback, but I hope you guys understood the context, that depending on this you can actually go and ask a lot of questions. So to visualize the data it has created in this, you have an option to paste in PowerPoint. Pretty interesting, right? So it says that to create this, it has also create this document, which is pretty nice. If I just go and say run, let's see what it is doing. And some of these things are coming from my out of box automation packages, which I have already installed, right? So in the previous session, since I already have access to these things, that's why it has given me. And now it says that in your download folders, I have created this file. Let's try to see that. Go to downloads. And here it is, right? So number of rating is equal to 3. It's a bit huge, I would say. It's scattered in the complete thing, but assuming that I have a lot of data, it might have done a good work, or it should do a good work, right? But the whole idea is, you guys can actually work with CSV, and it does pretty well with all these options as well, right? Okay, so for the next use case, what I have got is, I have a project documentation. Okay, so the project documentation talks about a project which is AI chatbot for this. It has a starting date, it has some objective, it has some milestone, and some of the compliance information, right? So if I just go and drag and drop this into the Autopilot for Everyone, which is kind of a project documentation, right? You can ask information about the project as well, right? So for example, you are a project manager and you have received some of the documents. It can be a minutes of meeting from Teams chat, or it can be simply an email, right? And I just want to know that what is the deadline of my project completion. So then it has gone to that and it has extracted that information, right? Other use case could be you already integrated it with some of the, let's say, email service where you have received an agreement from a customer over the email. With the existing out-of-box automations, you can download those agreements, ask the question, what is the deadline, what is this? You can ask how many phases are there. And the good part is it is also giving you some of the questions, right? So if I just utilize this one, which says that, can you provide me more details about the AI training into the phase 2? It is going to go back to the document and get us the answer, right? So this is again working on the same concept where we had a project document and you are able to ask questions, right? Next, for the last type of file, which is kind of a PDF, I would like to take a resume, right? So I have put my resume directly here. So this is kind of my trainer profile which I have created, right? So now you can be an HR who is receiving a lot of resumes. So if I just go and I drag and drop my resume directly onto this one, and then as HR you can ask question, right? So if I just go and ask what is the YouTube channel for, or maybe what is the YouTube channel, right? So I have just uploaded my resume and let's say I am an HR who is hiring, and this is just a vague question, right? So I just ask what is the YouTube channel, and I have that information embedded inside the PDF, I hope so, and it should give me that answer, right? But as an HR, you should be able to ask more kind of a concrete questions related to your requirement. So it says that based on this, it has given me this. It says that you have 2 million views, what is the channel link and all, it has got from the document, right? So now the other good part is it has also given me some of these prompts, but if I have to specifically ask about a role, right? So if let's say is this candidate good as a RPA trainer, right? So based on my profile, I am asking as an HR, right, that the candidate resume which I have uploaded, is it good? So it says that based on the information provided, he appears to be an excellent candidate for an RPA trainer. It shows me all that information, bit summarized in a way where it says that it has 10 plus experience, he has this certification, solution architect, training records, mentorship, right, educational content, talks about my YouTube, by the way these numbers have increased. So yeah, it has given me this information, right? So you can think it of a use case where you have a lot of resume, you just upload it and you can just ask questions and ask Autopilot to give you the answers, right? The other thing is, as we have already mentioned, you can always work with different kind of files, you can upload images, you can upload invoices, right? Ask it to give you the total, ask it to give you a lot of stuff, right? So now there might be unlimited use cases which you guys might have think of, right? By just having this tool in your hand, you can create a lot of projects, right? And with this, you can also integrate with the out-of-box packages, and that will give you a complete solution for end-to-end solutions, right? So yes, so that's simply I wanted to cover in this tutorial, that yes, we can upload file and we can do a lot of things, right? So what I want you guys to do is, based on this thing, first thing is I want you guys to explore the file upload, ask questions, give your feedback, test it, and what use cases comes to your mind after looking into that, let me know in the comments, right? Other thing I would suggest you to, whatever, if you are learning this new hot topic currently, post all your learnings on LinkedIn and let the world of RPA, UiPath recruiters, your company and your colleagues, that you are learning a new skills, that is definitely going to help you into building your network internally and in turn helping your career as well, right? So feel free to tag me in your LinkedIn post as well, and I will see you in the next video of Autopilot for Everyone, right? So with that, wrapping this video here. If you like this video, please do subscribe to the channel, and happy automation. Bye.